All right, you guys have asked for it, and you got it. Tecmo Bo. You got to have a pair on you to make your name Tecmo something and enter a tournament. Tecmo Bo is that dude. Mort hasn't changed his name to Tecmo Mort yet. Something's holding him back. Tecmo Bo said, fuck, I'm going for it. I'm that man.
Joined online Tecmo in 2011, and I went with that name.
He knows. In 2011, he joined the online community, Tecmo Bo. And the Tecmo Flow saw that, and he was like, hold on.
Tecmo Flow, that's me.
And I'm coming at him.
Mort is also on Tecmo 101.
He is. He is. I'm talking a little shit. Now, if James wins this game, he changes his name to Tecmo James. Okay? He just changes it to that.
You gotta take the title of Tecmo and the name.
So Tecmo Marriage.
I still prefer the matchup thing, but in a small tournament, I don't mind changing it.
You wanna change the names here?
That needs to happen.
Let me get the names updated for you guys. So, Raiders in the first slot. So we got Raiders and Tampa Bay.
And you did. Yeah. But then you played the even match.
Hey, you're only as good as your last game. Like,
Mort is still salty from the loss. I'm just going to throw that out there.
Hey, but the way he won the earlier round, you know, can't be too salty. Time for Vinny to run for his life for four quarters. I can just advance if you want. That's cool with me. We can do a coach game.
I would rather do a coach game.
They're calling for a coach game here. That would be an interesting matchup.
Get it over.
More interesting for the players than the viewers, I think.
This could get ugly quick, BrewDog is calling.
Yeah, it will get ugly quick. He is right. It's like you guys definitely a mismatch here.
Which way?
We got a tier 2 team versus a tier 3 team. But don't underestimate Vinny Testaverde.
Yeah, I've learned that just from watching some games. The dude is pretty clutch.
He's pretty quick.
I had to Google the guy. I was like, hold on, man, who is this dude? After watching a couple Tecmo games, I was like, who is this guy? I called him Tetrazzini for a while. Remember Chicken Tetrazzini? They used to give us that in school. Did y'all eat that in school?
I don't know what you're talking about, man. I remember Rectangle Pizza, though.
You remember that? Man, that pizza, dude. So good.
It was so good. I don't know why, but it was disgusting at the same time. I don't know how something can be simultaneously so good and disgusting.
Yeah, I think whenever I think of simultaneously terrible and delicious Rectangle Pizza, is what comes to mind. The only thing that comes to mind.
I think it's because when you're a child, you just want pizza every day, and when they give you the option for pizza.
Well, we got a Raiders touchdown, Bo Jackson.
Tecmo Bo doing work right away.
Can't say that I'm surprised. Let's see what Vinny Testaverde's got for us, though.
Dog bone controller. I don't see very many dog bones.
I saw that. He brought his own controller, pulled it out of his pocket, and I was like, what is this? Dog bone? SNES controller. It's almost a Super NES.
Oh, it's a dog bone.
Yeah, I don't even remember that from back in the day.
There's definitely a difference between that one and the SNES controller.
No, yeah, for sure. The SNES is straight across the top. Ooh. Nice little JJ there.
You want to get up and get one of these guys on the commentary? Anybody care to come?
Yeah, sure. It's open.
It's open. Yeah, man. So we got Joe in. You know, a lot of people have been asking who you were. Hold on. After this play, I'm going to give everybody a quick visual. After this play is over.
Passing
speed. All right. So this is Joe. So what's up?
What's up, everybody? How's it going?
That's Joe right there. Cool. And then back to the game. So, Joe, you had a pretty interesting run there. You had no losses.
No losses in group play. Yeah.
You were top seeded. You got to pick your team. Who'd you pick?
Pick the Eagles. I got the second overall pick.
Yep. Nice pick.
Would have been my first overall pick.
QB Eagles. That would have been your first overall.
Yeah, if I'd been given the first overall.
Is it the QB? Is that the reason why?
It's the QB, and then he's got three of the passing options. So when in doubt, you can chuck it up.
Okay, cool.
You can scramble all day, mm-hmm. and then if you have a mathematical advantage, the defender is chucked up. And I got quite a few of those in the game before.
Okay, yeah. So
sometimes that goes your way, too.
Pay dividends. So you ended up going head-to-head, though, with Josh.
No, I went to play Phil.
Phil, right. Yeah, Phil had notes. Let me tell you. In your previous match, Phil was sitting down, and he was scouting you out.
That's cool, yeah.
He was taking some notes, so he was prepared. Yeah. But enough about the history, I guess. I just wanted to give a little orientation. Let's talk about this matchup.
Yeah.
So I'm not super familiar with Tecmo, and what I've heard is this is just an ugly matchup for Tampa Bay. I mean, the defense is able to penetrate.
Yeah, it really comes down to having Tampa Bay's defense. Sometimes he's enough. Sometimes he can cover the field and he's fast enough to track down Bo Jackson on the ground. It's just a matter of whether Haddix can do it all or they were playing the Raiders and keep Haddix guessing so that he can run and pass. Because it really helps for the Buccaneers to know to anticipate whether it's going to be a run.
Now I see Mark spends a lot of time, switching characters, switching players in, making substitutions. What calls for you to like? If you're the Raiders, under what circumstance would you take him out? Or would you ever?
You would never take him out because he's so fast.
Is there like fatigue in the game?
No fatigue. He could go into bad condition.
Okay.
And then he would be one of the fastest running backs in the game.
Gotcha.
People's playbook had some Jackson runs, some Allen runs.
Uh-huh.
Marcus Allen. So it's up to the person manning them whether they want to. Maybe put Jackson at the second running slot to give him a couple different running plays. You're never really going to take him out.
A JJ for the touchdown
to Ron Hollins. Ball's a natural tight end. It's the Lions. They're putting him at the top wide receiver. It's putting Carrier down low. Carrier's kind of the wide receiver.
Okay. Well, looking like, from where I see it, looking like he's in a pretty favorable position from what he thought it would go. I mean, he's up a score.
That was a really nice time pass because they got Haddix diving. Yeah. So that gave the Raiders 30 extra yards.
So I see in the chat someone mentioned his rushing throws. I was going to ask the question. I noticed one of the things like more regulator kind of put me hip to is when you're the QB, you can kind of play, towards the line,
threaten with the rush, with the QB rush, and then dump it off, you know, across the field. Does that type of strategy work towards a defense like the Raiders defense? Is Testa Verde, like, quick enough?
You could. Testa Verde's the main thing is that he's so fast that he can scramble. He can hide time and let a play develop. And if the defender, no matter what the team is, has the backup and defend, then he can scramble for maybe a first down.
Ooh, 1 second on the clock. He squeezed that in there.
Mm-hmm. But now it's decision time because...
Do I go for the three?
He's on the 4 yard line. So he could go for the kill with the TD. Mm-hmm. Or he could go for the more conservative. And he's calling a touchdown. So we'll. I need to kill him.
Yeah, he's
calling it.
Oh, yeah, he's calling it.
So he's going to try to sneak it in with Jackson. He's playing with the line hand.
That's
a great stop by the Buccaneers. The drones come in there.
That's all drones. That was me.
The Buccaneers drones get a lot of crap for being just pieces of. Yes, but they held their point and they dove at Jackson, so Haddix could block off the more easier routes. So.
Can't help but look back on that play. Yeah, can't help but look back on that play if we come down to the game.
Yeah,
you know,
sure.
He could be winning from the field goal and he has to get a touchdown or something like that.
Yeah. That was a nice toss of the carrier, but it was deflected by the defender. Fumble, the Raiders D gets that fumble. That's pretty huge. James was hoping to.
That's massive.
Was hoping to move the chains, but now. Now Jay Schroeder just scrambled for a few yards. It's a new quarter, so we're going to check some conditions here. Schroeder is the natural starter, but if he sinks in his condition, the backup, your line increases. Nice to go around to where the goal. He's very fast, so he's able to see past the defenders. And it's hard for Haddix to cover the whole field there because he's up top. He's able to go around with the second wide receiver really fast. Nice time to just go around. Awesome. Pretty good kick return. He's got really high hitting power, but safely goes out.
I don't know how you trade both. It doesn't matter if you're playing both.
Man, I tell you, I've learned a lot just from being at this tournament and commentating and getting to see how different players, what kind of plays they pick and different strategies and then having people like you walking through it. So good stuff, man.
Yeah,
I know
for sure, yeah.
The people in the chat right now are probably all seasoned players, but might be, some viewers later that'll definitely appreciate the commentary. So thank you.
Doug says has to, not sure what it is.
I think it means play. Is that what he means?
Yeah, he's either saying that I think he was predicting
the
number. Predicting what
which play?
Yeah.
That should be GG. Well, it's up by four. You know, if you can keep them to a three. This is third quarter, so yeah. I mean,
definitely wants to hold them to a field goal. You don't want to be playing.
Yeah.
No
way you can let a touchdown happen here.
You can chuck it up to carrier, but that's not the hot Buccaneers, they got a team that's a little bit higher tier than them.
See, this is what I'm talking about. That's the kind of stuff that, you know, I think separates, you know, my mindset in Tecmo from, you know, top players. And that's something like when I do play the game again, I'm going to be threatening more with those types of quarterback rushes.
So John again found the extremely fast really call on the go route from the wide receiver two there. That's right. Run, but
blocked it.
Just hit that. So.
tell you what, man. Keep them to three. Keep them to three, and you know you're still gonna miss. Pretty much gonna have to convert on the next. On the next go.
Ooh, that was an amazing defensive stand there.
Are you trying to turn the game score?
Yeah.
Oh, look. Okay, we got Chalabet versus Phil actually having it simultaneously. I'll get you guys a score update in just a moment.
Did they
block field goal just now? Okay. Yeah, that's worth mentioning.
That's rare, I think.
Ooh. Off the mark. Oh man, called the play again. Forced the pass. Interception. It is definitely. That's a painful. That's a tough pill to swallow. But I gotta admit, if you're James right now, you gotta feel like things are going a little bit better than you thought it was. I mean, early on, he was like. Pretty much think it was going to be terrible.
Yeah, definitely still in it. Like, definitely has a chance to.
He gets a fumble, man. Call pass three. Let's see. Brewdog wants to see him air it out. Not happy with all the run plays. Gonna need
that one for Brewdog.
Brewdog, you happy now, Brewdog?
Brewdog, are you happy? That was a Jeff just aired
just
out.
Too predictable, Brewdog. Oh yeah, you gotta like that though, Brewdog. Come on.
It doesn't even matter if it works though. So it doesn't matter who Jeff
hey Brewdog, he gave you the nod of approval. He liked that play. Finally he said, what are you doing? Bring it into the end zone. All right, let's see what he's got. I'm gonna have to.
It looks like he's gonna be up to Ron Hall. See if he can pull him down over Eddie Anderson. Let's see, he's got a chance. And he gets it.
Can he popcorn him? Oh, he got him! He got him, all right.
He's got the TD. He's gotta find a way to get the ball back.
You gotta love. All right, we're back. Sorry for the drop frames there, but it looks like Tecmo Bowl ended up clutching it out over James, 21-17.
That was a really entertaining game to watch.
That was
a lot of runs by Bo.
Yeah, I was going to say Bo Jackson.
Able to contain him for only 85 yards off 20 runs, so that's pretty impressive.
Absolutely.
James Frederick being pretty efficient, completing 2/3 of his passes. Willie Gault there, only 3 completions.
Good games,
man. Definitely move the chains a number of times at critical times.
Mm-hmm.
And it's fun to see a Ron Hall up there with over 100 yards. He's usually carrier. He's the one that kind of carries the Buccaneers for their receiving. So,
no doubt.
Not terribly surprising. Testa Verde is the lead rusher for the Buccaneers, but it also looks like James wasn't in it enough to get that Gary Anderson. That gets off to pretty good clip when they're against teams that the Buccaneers are even with, but you got to make adjustments when you're playing a team that's kind of a tier above you, which is what the Buccaneers are doing.
Okay, cool. So thanks a lot, man.